You start babbling about, you know, this lifetime product that, you know, you guys swear by. It's the only product you use. And you talk about the long time warranty that it has and how great it's going to be. And, you know, and what you're doing is like you're raising red flags in the mind of somebody who's moving out and they don't really care about that sort of product, but you forgot to ask. What's going on, guys? This is Tanner with Trade Thrive, and I want to talk to you about the difference between estimating and selling. And a lot of you guys only have an estimating process when in turn, if you develop a sales process, I guarantee you will increase your sales. Now, what is the difference? Well, an estimating process is the primary focus on the project itself. You going in, doing what you think you're supposed to do, and you think the customer wants, which is to deliver you a quote based on what you believe the materials will be and what you believe the labor will be for the project. And yes, that has its place and it's very important, but it's not as important as focusing on what the homeowner needs and the homeowner wants, because people buy from people they trust. And if you only give people a price, that's all they will have to compare you to. And a lot of you people say, hey, you know, these people are cheap. You know, they only want the cheapest price. And my response to that is there's no such thing as a cheap customer. There's just an uneducated customer, and you haven't built enough value as to why that person should pay what it is that you're charging. Now, here's where I'm getting at is that you have four different types of homeowners, okay? You have people that are selling their house to move. You have people that are investors. These are house flippers and renters. And then you have people that are buyers. They're buying to move in. And then you have people that are, this is the last and probably my favorite category, people that are living in their house that are either hiring you to upkeep their house or to upgrade their house. So you can't tell me that going in and doing the same estimating process every single time is going to yield you great results, because we have four different categories of homeowners that have their own subcategories. And the problem is that you're entering there with the same process thinking that you're going to get exponential results when it's not the case. What you need to do is you need to have what's called a fluid sales approach. And that fluid sales approach is based off of the premise of asking one very important question. What's the story? Why am I here? And you know, we get into talking about, you know, how great our company is and, you know, the great products that we use and why we're so awesome and why they should hire us, when in turn, you know, you could be talking about the wrong things and it could be scaring them away because you're talking about what's important to you and not what's important to them, or you're only focused on the project itself and instead you're missing the point of why you're there. So let me give you an example. If you have somebody that's moving out of their house and you come up to them, you say, hey, you know, happy to be here. Thanks so much. And I'm just going to tell you a little bit about what we do and how we do it. And you start babbling about, you know, this lifetime product that, you know, you guys swear by. It's the only product you use. And you talk about the long time warranty that it has and how great it's going to be. And, you know, and what you're doing is like you're raising red flags in the mind of somebody who's moving out and they don't really care about that sort of product, but you forgot to ask, right? So that's how easy it is to get off track. And that's how easy it is to speak the wrong language to somebody when your job as a salesperson, not an estimator. We're no longer estimators. If you're watching this, you're not an estimator. You need to be a salesperson, because this is what's gonna grow your business. This is gonna help you hire more crews. This is what's gonna help you get to a position where if you are currently in the mud, if you are currently in the production, it's gonna help you get out of that production. The more jobs you have, the more people you can hire, the longer you can keep these people busy, and the longer you can position yourself in a CEO role, which anyone who has a business wants to be in. So the approach is different than estimating. And this is the kicker here, is that what we're doing is we have one process. We have one way of doing things. Okay, I'm gonna come in, I'm gonna look at this house. I have one product that I use, I have one price that I give, and that's how it's gonna be. When in reality, what you need to do is start uncovering what the motivation is of your buyers. You need to start uncovering what's important to your buyers, and then you have to adjust your sales approach based off of that. So an example would be for somebody who's moving out of their house. You know, if they tell me that they're moving, I say, hey, what's the story? Why are we here today? What would you call us for? And, oh, well, you know, we've been here for 10 years. We're getting ready to move. We talked to our realtor and they said that we want to spruce things up a little bit. It might be a good idea so we can get the house listed, you know, and sold a lot faster. And I would say, great. Oh, my gosh. We help people in this exact position all the time. And one thing you'll like is that we have a really good middle of the road product that's going to do a great job, very appealing. But most importantly, we work in teams of four. So looking at this project, should only take us 3 days. We can help you get the house listed as soon as possible. How much more valuable is that approach versus, oh yeah, so yeah, we use this really high-end product you're gonna love, and you're just babbling about things that aren't even important to this person. And you're going to find that out at the end when you try to present your price, and then all the momentum's lost. You've been selling in the wrong direction, all because you didn't ask the right questions. So this is called a fluid sales approach. And if you're in contracting, really it works with almost any business, but I'm talking to contractors now, is that you need to be discovering what it is that's important to your customers. Because as I discussed, we have four different categories. So how can we have one estimating process for four different types of homeowners that have subcategories, right? You know, here's another example. People that are living in their house that are upkeeping, right? So let's say someone gets an HOA letter and they're forced to paint their house. You know, they don't want to paint their house. They don't like you. They didn't budget for this. They don't want to spend the money. At first, this type of person is going to go for the cheapest. But unless you build value as to how you're going to be the savior and how you're going to protect them from going through this horrible experience again, well, wait a minute. Now we have a different angle to show this person that you are the right choice at the price you want to sell the job for. So let me give you an example. You call me over. You tell me that the HOA is going to, you know, fine you unless you get this house painted because it's cracking and it's fading and all this stuff. I'd say, hey, great. Hey, listen, I know this is probably something you didn't anticipate doing, but I want to make sure that you know that if you go with us, we're going to use a high quality, high warranty product that's going to guarantee for the next 25 years, if anything like this should happen again, the manufacturer is going to cover it. Okay. And wait, even better, we offer a 7-year warranty on our work. So you won't have to go through this again should you decide to hire us. Do you see the difference? And the difference is that I ask the right questions to discuss what's most important to the homeowner, so then I can use my fluid sales approach to identify how I am the best solution to their problem and I can alleviate the concerns in the future, guys. But it all depends on what is most important to that specific homeowner at that specific time, guys. So, you know, I hope you got something out of this today. You know, I really want to dive deeper into this sales thing. If you're listening to this, you know, and you have questions and maybe you're in a different trade, this works with every trade. You throw a trade at me and I guarantee that I can help you identify the right things so you can build value in the right ways. But if you're going into jobs with one estimating approach and you're not selling, you're just kind of looking at a scope and thinking that that's what's going to, you know, make the homeowner happy, you're mistaken, because you could be speaking the wrong language to somebody and, you know, you're eliminating any opportunity you have of closing the deal. So knowing this, guys, think about your sales approach. Think about the different ways you can build value to the different types of homeowners, right? In your specific business, your specific trade, what's your warranty look like for people that want a long-term result? What does your process look like for people who need to sell the house or rent the house out? How do you build value to these specific types of people? And then have that in the back of your mind. So when you come across somebody, boom, you can spit it out right away. And if that's not important enough to you to prepare ahead of time, you know, then unfortunately I can't help you. But I think that there's a lot of you out there that, you know, care about this sort of thing, are tired of fumbling around in circles, are tired of leaving, you know, instead of delivering a quote, collecting a check, and, you know, scheduling your team ahead. So that's the goal, guys. My name is Tanner with Trade Thrive. If you haven't already jumped into the Painting Business Sales Academy, I want you to go to sellpaintjobs.com, sellpaintjobs.com. If you haven't already downloaded the pricing calculator, guys, it's going to help you come up with profitable margins so you know what your pricing is way ahead of time. Okay, you can come up with accurate pricing for painting jobs within minutes. Okay, any painting job you give me, I can come up with a price accurately and be happy with that price within 5 minutes by using this calculator. If you already have the calculator, just go to sellpaintjobs.com/PBSA. That's short for Painting Business Sales Academy, where I go over this entire idea of selling, not estimating, in a full length over 14 lesson course to help you strategically develop your sales process. Thanks, guys, for listening, watching, wishing you all the best in your contracting journey.